Listen, I understand Democrats, and I used to understand Republicans. There's something going on in this country that I don't understand, and that's the Tea Party. I have never met or dealt with politicians that don't mind losing, that don't mind taking down their party, the Republican Party, or their speaker, or the country, or the president, or the party for that matter. And so politics is changing for me at this late age, that I have to deal with a cult type of group of people. If there was just for the purpose of understanding, I'd be a Democrat no matter how long I would have been anything else, just so I would know what is the agenda. When a handful of people can control a larger number of people to repeal a law that has been passed by the House, the Senate, and declared constitutional by the courts, and they campaign on the issue that it should be repealed, you know, this is past civics 101. This is illness. And now I heard someone say today that he supports immigration reform, but because the president wants to destroy the Republican Party, he could not support anything that he would recommend. This means that you're so anxious to kill the captain that you don't mind going down with the ship. So when you start talking about Democrats and Republicans, they're changing the whole thing, and that's the reason I said that it shouldn't be that a person has to spend all of his time disassociating himself from the label that he selected to run under. It shouldn't be. And it's not fair to the voters. We should find out what is it that he intends to do and to try to improve the Republican Party so that he can say how proud he is of Republican Party. And I should be saying I'm more proud. But unfortunately, it's a race to the bottom. And I can absolutely see where it's possible for this great country to collapse. I had really thought that those who hold most of the wealth in this country, that may or may not be concerned about the general welfare, would not allow a handful of people to kill the goose that has laid their platinum eggs. But they waited to the last minute before they pulled the chain. And irreparable harm has been done because the whole world knows how fragile our leadership is in the United States of America. And there's no outrage. Not only is there no outrage from the business community and the chambers of commerce, but I don't know whether any of you were there, but Medicaid, Medicare, Social Security, jobs, education, I don't care whether they're Jew, Gentile, or Muslims, or more, these are spiritual issues for the salvation of a strong people. And so you don't even have to like people if you want to be internationally competitive. You need strong, healthy, educated people. And they say that because Obama wants it, they don't want it. That's insanity. Insanity. And I just wish that more priests and ministers and rabbis, like the Pope said, leave the gay questions alone and get on with building a country that can be more tolerant.
I just one last question. We've been writing stories the last couple of days in the Daily News about young black people buying items at the Barney's.